brother Riley forgetting his pilot's license. Where the hell is that motherfucker?
To my father's black card, to my black card.
God, I haven't done Sambuca since I was 20 years old.
Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back. Thanks for tuning in. It's episode 40 of my Far Cry 3 walkthrough here on the PC. Now, we are at where we leave off. What was this called? Next Diner. Oh, my. I'm going to shoot somebody. Stop taking credit for my shits. Anyway, we have this wanted mission on the board. I did all my buy and sell. You know what I should check? I did a little bit of crafting, but one thing I haven't checked on lately are my skill points. I mean, you can see I have one sitting there. So let's do, what is this? Soft landing. Reduce damage taken from falls by 25%. That might be, oh, goddamn, that might be of use. What else we have? We got the bow. I think this was for 50. Draw and fire arrows 50% faster. Goddamn. Or the dual death from above is what really caught my eye when I first came in here. That's what caused me to chuckle. Because you know what? It might have come in handy last episode when I died there by those old burned out cars. Anyway, let's grab it. Let's grab it just to have it. I could have sworn I've gotten inked up as well before. These achievements, I don't know what's going on with them. Anyway, jump onto them with space. Yes, yes. Just need to be close to two of them. And you can see he takes one out midair. And then as he's getting up from just embarrassing and humiliating that one poor soul, he jabs the other guy with his machete. So that's good. We've got that. And that's some crazy-ass glare coming off of that board there a second ago. Anyway, let's go and do this wanted mission. I'll follow Rocky Out tradition and use a knife to kill a pirate roaming around a local farm. So we'll do that, and then we'll worry about what else needs to be done. Let me see where we're going. Oh, it's bringing us to where we're actually heading here, in fact. So that's nice. I don't know if I really need the waypoint up. Anyway, let's grab a Jeep. We're good to go. Got all the ammo I need, I require. Did all my selling for the most part. Actually, no, I didn't. I'm still carrying a couple of bear hides. I remember seeing a real surplus of leaves in my rucksack. And of course, I've got this real bam piece of shit rucksack I'm running right now. Real low-level rucksack. It's like a rucksack that gets left on the subway because nobody wants it anymore, you know? You pick up at the Salvation Army. Some crap like that, you know? That's the kind of rucksack I'm rolling right now. Not pleased. Anyway, which one's the boss man? Well, I doubt it's Molotov Man. Oh, there he is. That's the boss man right up there. Molotov Man in the back of the head while Heavy had his back to me. Like it. But they're going to be all over this area now. This is a nice little area, though. I mean, look at this. I've got good retreat, good cover in this river here that I can use to swing around, reposition, and stay out of there. Stay concealed, you know? Stay off their radar. And another Molotov Man coming in to replace. Maybe a Heavy there replaced or revived his ass. Who knows? Who knows? We get both of them here. Oh no, now watch it, Brody. Oh shit, Brody. Into the drink with you, sir. Save yourself. And of course, that's probably why all these Molotovs are running around here. To force you into the drink. To force you into the drink. The developers, you know, they're smart like that. They're evil. They're evil people. Evil people. But they're smart. They know what's up. And why are we swimming so slow here, Brody? Pick up the pace. Get the lead out, sir. You can hear the battle cries coming out. The drunken battle cries coming out from the Molotov Man back there. They've set the jungle ablaze. What else is new? Those guys, they're just pure. Complete lunatics. The lot of them. Alright, what do we have here? Can't see anything. I have to do him in with the blade. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to get in there and close this ground. And while the rest of them are all distracted on the far side of this little, I don't know what you call it. Oh, it's a farm. That's right. It was a farm. Well, the rest of them are all distracted. I may be able to just sneak in here. So let's see if I can do it. Do it quietly. Gonna have to hustle here, Brody, now. They're gonna be turning around here any moment now, I would imagine. Are they posted right up in here? Oh, it's a heavy. It's a goddamn heavy. That's a bad idea. You're gonna blow yourself up. Let's toss one in there. Oh, you're done, fool. Oh, now they're gonna be all over here again, Brody. Did you escape unnoticed? It appears you have, sir. Oh, the Molotovs are coming in. The Molotovs are coming in. I got something for you, though, sucker. Oh, you're done, fool. He doesn't even know where to run to. He's running back into the building. Don't you take out the boss, man, you crazy fool, you. Don't you take him out. Oh, I got him. Oh. Are you kidding me? How did he spot me there? I guess you can do him in with a knife or take him out with a Molotov, man. A man's suicide run, you know? I don't know. That was odd. Surprised I got the kill there and completed it successfully. He did take out the boss, man, though. Pretty funny. Look at all the chickens running around here. Goddamn chickens. The chickens on the Far Cry 3 island grow up to be cassowaries. So you gotta be careful walking around here. Gotta be careful. All right, what else do we have? So there's the I can't believe that. Something new every goddamn episode, you know. This is unreal. I can't believe the Molotov man ran in there and took out the rest of the crew. I don't know, maybe I got both heavies. I really wasn't paying attention. I may have put down both heavies with that one C4. And I'm actually kind of lucky that the C4 didn't take out the boss man while he was in here. But amazingly, that Molotov man running in here and probably came rushing in here like a madman, you know. And the boss man probably turned around and was like, "What, huh?" And you know what? And then Molotov man just like ran up to him for help. He's like, "Put me out, sucker! Piss on me if need be." And boss man was just caught off guard. He didn't know what to do at that point, and died. Suffered probably smoke inhalation. I think that's what probably put him down, was the smoke inhalation. Yeah. Anyway, let's head for the radio tower. That's enough of that. That is enough of that. Yes. Moving on. And did I get any good loot? I wasn't even paying attention while I was stripping those bodies down. Cleaning out their pockets. Probably not much. You guys gotta let me know if I'm picking up photos of dwarves, though. You guys gotta let me know. I need 7 of them before this walkthrough ends. Because I will be Snow White and 7 Dwarfs by the end of this. I am determined. Of course, I always do those quick sells. And never even really take a second look at my loot. And you shouldn't in Far Cry for the most part. You know, it's just such crap out here. Such crap. Anyway, it wasn't too bad of a run here to the radio tower. Hopefully it's a pretty simple climb. It's looking a little rough up there, though. Anything I can see down here? No, it doesn't look like there's any chests or anything. Alright. I don't know who designed the base of this tower, but pretty poor design. Starting things off, you know. These stairs should have probably been this way, you know. But, you know what? I'll forgive him. Oh, look at this. And he forgot to put a complete flight of stairs in right here. Just figured he'd dangle some ropes up here for for anybody that wanted to get up to that next level. Goddamn. Anyway, let's not waste too much time here. I'd like to get as much in on this episode as I possibly can. Look at this. Some guy just chilling up here. I wonder what did hit him in. Let's go and inspect the body. Brody, come on now. Hold on to it. Don't get all dramatic, yeah? Look at him. He's sitting here funny. I would say by the looks of things, it looks like at one point he was handcuffed, yeah. Yes. Some kind of kinky sex act was taking place here by his sexy little pose. But I would say there were definitely some spiked handcuffs, some pink, lacy, yet spiked and studded handcuffs. Whoa, Brody! Oh, my God. Brody. What are you doing, you bloody idiot? Oh, those developers, they put that corpse there for pure distraction. Pure distraction, and that's what happened. Thank God we're starting right here, though. Thank God. And I don't know how many episodes ago I said it. I said one of these times, one of these times I'm gonna fall off of one of these things and fall to my death. Fall to my death. And this was one of those times. Yes. All right. Are we at the right radio tower? I think we are. Oh, here we go, Brody, getting all dramatic again. Come on, man. Suck it up. Get up there. And apparently now the body has moved, so that we don't do that again. Lots of cash here though to find. Look at this, $15. What else we got? 21. That's 36. And $44. And I don't know how he moved over there. I don't like it though. All right, Brody. God damn it, man. You almost did it again. Two times in a row. Where are we going now? This crap. Oh, come on. I hate wandering these beams. I mean, look at this. Coming off of here, a big wind comes in, a big gust of wind. You're done for. You're done for at that point. Oh, Brody. Stop it. Every time he's on this side of the tower, it's all dramatic. You know, you got to be all dramatic. The camera must be on this side. You know? Trying to put on a show for the people of the internet. All right, so we're down on our knees again here. Crossing some beams, some rickety beams. And we're almost there. This has been all ropes and beams. All ropes and beams. And, of course, one death. One death. All right, look at this. He can't even get on the ladder right. God damn it, Brody. Are you drunk, fool? Are you drunk? Were you swigging the hooch before you made this climb? Probably, sir. Probably. All right, a little bit of loot. Please be something good. $34. $34. Well, better than a doll head. Not as good as a photo of a dwarf, though. Definitely not. Even though a photo of a dwarf only worth a dollar on the island, it's priceless in the heart of Jason Brody. Yes. Priceless. Alright, let's take a look. Got some old bunkers down here. That's where the Trial of the Rock Yacht is. I did see the rock over there. Now, we were already here at the old farm. And as I grab my tea, while we see a little shipwreck over here, probably just a few crates, maybe a relic. Maybe a relic. And full bars coming in again. Don't know what the deal is. We've already achieved full bars. And there's the phone going, and it will be ignored. It will be ignored. God damn it. People! Don't you realize I'm trying to record here for the internet, for the good people of the internet. And I love saying that. All right, where am I heading? Well, we got the health drop quest over there. And, well, we do need to get to those old bunkers as well. Trial of the Rock Yacht. I think we'll do the Trial of the Rock Yacht before we do the, before we do the supply drop run, maybe if we get lucky, the supply drop run will bring us down here somewhere. And that's just pure luck if that happens. Oh, and we have some tappers, some tapers, some tapirs out here on this island, on this portion of the island. And we'll be going to hunting them down, and some deer as well. So that's nice. That's nice. All right, so we've got a few things to do. Also have a race there by the looks of things that has yet to be done. So what did I say? We're gonna do the, what are we gonna do first? The old bunkers, Trial the Rock Yacht challenge here. Wherever the hell it is. It was off in this general direction, though. And then we'll get back up here, do the health supply run, and start getting some things done here. We take another look at the map. I'm all lost. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Going the wrong way. There we go. I would imagine there's going to be a letter of the lost in here. Just be my guess. Yeah, there we go. Old bunkers. Old bunkers that are points of interest. Well, they usually have letters of the lost. Alright, if I can just grab this thing. God damn it, he's got a real death grip on this sucker. Jungle Journal coming in for what? The third or fourth time now? Goddamn achievements. All messed up here. And that's it. That's it. That's all we really need out of the area. What's going on? Oh, we've got a little garbage picker over here looking for some relics of her own. No? Anyway, let's take a look. So we need 315 for top score. We need 300 for the maximum little bonus that we get, the $500. So 315 is what we're shooting for. It's called Bullseye. Oh, not liking the sounds of this. Not liking the sounds of this. There's going to be some sniping, obviously. All right, you better get your snap on, sir. Big points to be had here, of course. Big points. Headshots are worth more, right? Oh, goddamn. It's going to take me probably a couple tries to really get into a good snap groove. Go for those big points. Go for those big points. I really wish I had one more zoom setting on this sucker. But I I'm missing everything. Missing everything. There we go. Now things are starting to come together. Shooting a little high there. Again. You know what I'm not doing? Steadying my breath. I don't know why I'm not. I don't like the SVE, personally. Not a big fan of this rifle. Especially for going for headshots with the extra scope on here. Actually, there we go. Now I'm starting to find my footing. Get a good groove going. I don't know why I shot that. It seemed kind of pointless. Need some of my time barrels, though. Should grab that. That was a nice little headshot. Oh my god, there's quite a few of them down there. Damn. They're piled up thick there. Piled up thick. Really need to be bringing in the headshots, and I'm just not. I don't even have to reload this sucker, amazingly. You can just go crazy with the thing if you wanted to. Either that, or he's just reloading so fast that the human eye can't even pick it up. But I got 30 seconds left. Oh my god, I need to get to 315. I'm so far off the mark right now. Shooting a little high there. This is awful. This is just an awful display. Oh, there we go. A couple of really nice headshots to pull me out of that rut I was in there. This guy was really pissing me off because I've missed at least a full clip's worth of shots on him already. There we go. Finally got one in his ear as he advanced. Picked off the guy that was in there to replace him. There we go. Am I at 315 yet? 290. Getting close. We're closing in on it. Need some headshots, though. Coming down this final stretch. There we go. 340. Oh, my God. Let the trials begin. Challenge. That's a new one. That's a new one. And did I ever kick it into a overdrive there coming down that final stretch? God damn. God damn. Beautiful. A little slow to start things off. But like I said, I got to find my groove when I pick up a new weapon like that, you know? Anyway, let's back out. No need to do it a second time, although it was pretty fun. That was one of the more enjoyable ones that we've done so far. Actually, they're all pretty good in their own way, in their own right. All right, now where are we heading? I think we're just going to go straight back up this hill. Now, I don't know what I want to do. I guess it would be smarter to do the kind of the race first, because doing the race will bring us right back to the starting point of it, and then I can go and do the health supply run. Because I won't be going back, you know, it won't be bringing me back. And hopefully, the health supply run, like I said, takes me down, takes me south towards that other outpost that is in this quadrant. And then we can kind of just close the chapter on this quadrant altogether. So, where is the race? Over here. Got a few chests. You know what? I'm gonna go out on a limb, and I'm gonna say there's gonna be a photo of a dwarf in one of these. Gold chain. Well, almost as good as a photo of a dwarf. Mini flashlight, not even close. Not even close. It's good for those dark nights when you're trying to view your photos of dwarves. But no good without one. No good without one. It's only a photo of a dwarf accessory at the most, you know. Anyway, Zeke, what's up, son? Still donning that shaggy old goat, aren't you? All right, so what are we doing? Island Racing League, Rook Point Express. Well, we'll do the expert. That's what I try to complete them on anyway. Hopefully we're not here too long, losing all our cash, all our bankroll. But like I said, I think on the last race, Zeke, he does need a new razor. He does need a new razor. So, you know, it might be good to lose one to him once in a while. So he can get a proper trim going on that shaggy old goat that has... I don't know, it's got fleas. It's got things bigger than fleas living in there. Whoa, where am I going here? Going the wrong way. I saw the arrow pointing up, and I had this itch in my... I got this itch in my throat. I think I'm coming down with something, you know. As winter is setting in here in Canada. Got some snow out there today. God damn. And so bear with me, you know. If I'm sounding a little hoarse, well, that's why. That's why. Anyway, okay, so we've recovered pretty nicely here. These rocks, you know, gotta watch out for them. Look at that. You catch them just wrong with the tires, and you'll be sent all squirrely, even if they are just wee little rocks. But you know what? With Brody driving, it's... Ooh, where are we going here? Oh, goddamn, we gotta get on the jet ski. Well, this is gonna be a fail already. Anytime Brody gets out, has to get on a wave runner, it's never gonna be a good, never gonna be a good run. We still have like 29 more gates to get through. Unreal, unreal. We better get into the zone here, Brody. Get into the zone, sir. Oh, this is a pretty easy run for the most part. And this is taking us way down to the southern tip of this island now. Did you see that big tower or statue or whatever the hell it was, lighthouse there in the distance? I did see that on the map when I was in there earlier. Hopefully, hopefully we can just ride this out on the wave runner. You know, hopefully we don't have to head back onto land. Nope. It's not gonna be like that. Anyway, out we get. Brody rolling the wrong way, sir. You're going back into the drink. Not a good thing. Get on the egg. Goddamn. It's like a triathlon here. Three different vehicles. What did we start off in? Oh, it was a Jeep. So now Jeep, Wave Runner, ATV, and oh, killing chickens, Brody. And really buggering that up. Oh, not too bad. Coming right in there on a nice line. What is that? That bird that's been following me. Must be a vulture expecting me to die out here. Expecting me to fail. Even the birds know how bad a driver Brody is. Look at this, some opposition right here. Out of the way, fool. I'm running a race, goddammit. Goddammit, man. We're there. Beautifully. 3.8 seconds left. It was a long goddamn race, but a good one. A good one. You can see a relic on the radar down there. Anyway, there's the $500 coming in. Zeke, I don't know where you're getting your cash from, sir, but it's always, always a pleasure doing business with you. Anyway, let me check the time here. I think we're really right at about the 20-minute mark at this point. Want to try your luck? I did. What are you... What are you doing, sir? Not in my playthrough, sir. Maybe off camera. I don't know. Anyway, I don't know, guys. I was just dirty. Just dirty. Nasty. Had no place here at Wild Earth Games. Anyway, okay, so we may have time. Oh, my God, my horse. My horse. My throat is so sore right now. God damn. I think we'll probably have time just to do the health supply run, so we'll give this a go. Alright, get the medical supplies on this vehicle. Well, we know this. It's $250, 500 XP, and let's roll. The old medical supply run in the old cargo van here, the old, I don't know what you call this exactly. A big old truck, though, is what it is. Big old truck. Bringing in a big shipment. Big shipment of medicine. Big shipment of morphine back here. And it's not even for the, you know, it's for the casual use, you know. It's not for, it's not for the needy. It's not for those in pain. It's for those to forget their worries. Lose themselves out here on the island. To numb themselves to the, their poor lives. But it's not for any type of physical pain. But it is a big old shipment. Big old shipment of morphine and one little packet of insulin for one poor sucker out here who has a serious drug addiction. And he has the diabetes as well. Yeah. So anyway, there we go. So another achievement, road trip. I would imagine we've probably gotten that one as well. What up, son? And this is the guy with the diabetes. So I hope you're feeling better, sir. Feeling better. Oh, he doesn't sound well.
Tastes worse coming back up.
Yeah, no kidding. Anyway, guys, thanks for stopping by. I think I'm going to wrap it here. Hopefully this took us a little bit south. Let me take a quick look here. No, it took us more east than anything. So I want to get down to the tip of this island. Another race right there. Did we do that? Yeah, no, we did. We did do that. We did Smuggler's Highway. And this should be the island hop. It's a little wave runner race through there. So we just have this to do down here. And that is the southernmost tip of the island. So we'll come down here, we'll do that, and then maybe if I can find a dune buggy down here, that would be ideal, and we can do a big run all the way up to Bad Town to go and meet Buck. But for next episode, starting things off, we'll do Broken Neck Home, do any work that's needed to be done in the area, and then maybe I will either make the drive or I'll just do a quick fast travel up to Buck and see what's next. See what's next in that main storyline. So guys, again, thanks for stopping by. Thanks for tuning in and checking things out. Always a pleasure to have you here. Hopefully you'll leave a like, leave a comment, let me know what you thought. And until next time, I'll remember...
I remember what she's cooking,
but remember why it hurts. Later.